The reading from the Gospel of John. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away, and the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because a hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that I do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also. They will listen to my voice, so there will be one flock, one shepherd. For this reason the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me. I lay it down of mine own accord. I have power to lay it down. I have power to take it up again. I have received this command from my Father. There are many names for God: Yahweh, Elohim, El Shaddai, the Almighty, Father. Many traits, as we each have a different relationship with God, and there are many names and titles for Jesus: Son of God, Son of Man, the Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd, of course, is a description in our Gospel reading. A shepherd who looks after the sheep. Interestingly enough, in those days, a shepherd was considered to be a non-person, not a citizen, but a non-person, someone who had no rights. David, the youngest son of Jesse, because he was the youngest, was a shepherd. And though his family loved him, he was not considered to have any worth. Read the first book of Samuel, chapter 17. David fought bear and lion to protect the sheep, which was his life, and so was inspired to stand against Goliath. You see, David's brothers were in the army that faced Goliath, so he had a personal connection. He may have been considered worthless, but for those for whom he had worth were in danger. He became as one with them. He wasn't a servant sent down with food. He was, in that instance, a brother. Jesus made a distinction between the hired hand and the shepherd. The hired hand runs away from the danger. The shepherd stays, because like David with his brother, the shepherd is invested in the sheep. It doesn't mean, if you are the shepherd, that there isn't any danger. There is, but there is always someone rooting for us, and we are called to be the body of Christ, which means we are always rooting for you. And this, of course, is where it falls short, because we are all fallible. We forget, we get busy, we judge, and then we are reminded of who we are, that we also struggle, that we also feel alone, that we also get it wrong. And we need someone rooting for us. We call ourselves back to ourselves, give ourselves the reality check, remind ourselves that we are no better. So then we can better turn our attentions once more to you. When you are struggling, when you need someone to tend, to care, to protect, to guide. But we don't do it from a position of authority. We do so because we understand your pain. This is Christianity. God became human, taking the form of humanity, personified in the prophet Jesus. Therefore, God understands our pain, our challenges, in short, our humanity. So we accept we are understood, therefore we should do our utmost to understand others. This doesn't take away the pain, the hardship, the difficulties of life, rather the reverse. Jesus went to the pain of the cross, but what it does do is try and help us identify a purpose in our lives. That purpose we may not achieve, it actually may just be a goal. So don't lose sight of the moment we live in. Jesus told a story about a man who worked so hard for his retirement, on the day he got there to enjoy it, he died. This moment is too precious to waste. It is a bit like driving. Keep an eye on the future, but live in the present. Recognise what has gone behind, but don't dwell on it. You see, the shepherd has the herd, that is, gather. That is at the moment. By herding them, the shepherd can tend to them because they are together. And when the stray is lost, the stray can't be guarded. But the shepherd then leaves the herd to find the lost. And there are lost sheep. Because a shepherd could only direct, cannot control, can only guide, but cannot dictate. The shepherd most of the time watches over and does nothing, but if the wolves appear, then the shepherd stays, whilst the hired hand runs, fleeing for their own lives. The shepherd knows the sheep, shares the night sky with them, shares danger with them, the pastures, the time. The shepherd and the sheep become synonymous as one. Jesus himself calls himself the Good Shepherd. Jesus is synonymous with us, his sheep. But just at the moment when we think we are the chosen ones, the special ones, Jesus reminds us that there are other sheep too, sheep we don't know or understand. The shepherd is here for us, for all. We have to start living like we believe that. For Jesus came not for those who don't need a doctor, but for the sick. In short, God came for those we term the God-forsaken. That is, no one is God-forsaken. This is what we should learn and let it affect our lives.